द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इज एनवायरमेंटल केमिस्ट्री. सो वॉट इज एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन? वी नो एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन इज बेसिकली द इफेक्ट ऑफ अनडिजायरेबल चेंजेस इन आवर सराउंडिंग. सो वॉट इज एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन? एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ अनडिजायरेबल चेंजेस इन आवर सराउंडिंग दैट हैव हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स ऑन प्लांट्स, animals and human beings. So what is environmental pollution? Environmental pollution is the effect of undesirable changes in our surrounding that have harmful effects on plants, animals and human beings. So all are affected by the environmental pollution, plants, animals and human beings. Now we will discuss about a new term which is pollutant. See, what is pollutant? Basically, pollutant is a substance which causes pollution. So, pollutant are the substance which causes pollution. So, we call it pollutant. Now, the physical state of pollutant. The physical state of pollutant can be solid, can be liquid, or can be gas. Basically, the concentration of pollutants. The concentration of pollutant is greater than in the natural abundance. So basically pollutants can be solid, liquid or gas, and in greater concentration than in natural abundance, and the concentration becomes more than their natural abundance. Why? Because of human activities or due to natural happenings. So pollutant can be solid, liquid or gas in greater concentration than in natural abundance and are produced due to human activities or due to natural happenings. Now we will discuss the two types of pollutants. One is degradable pollutant and another is non-degradable pollutant. See, so basically pollutants which can be degradable, the pollutants which can be degradable like discarded vegetables which rapidly break down by natural process, we call degradable pollutants. While on the other cases, the pollutants which are non-biodegradable, we call non-degradable pollutants. So basically, the pollutants which are slowly degradable and remain in the environment in an unchanged form for many decades. So the pollutants which are slowly degradable and remain in environment in an unchanged form for many decades. For example, substance which is DDT. DDT is diphenyl trichloroethane. So DDT is dichloro diphenyl trichloroethane. And also plastic materials, heavy metals and many chemicals, also nuclear waste once released into environment. So basically these all, DDT, plastic materials, heavy metals, many chemicals and nuclear wastes, comes under the category of non-degradable pollutants. So these pollutants are slowly degradable and remain in the environment in unchanged form for many decades. While what are the degradable pollutants? Those pollutants which can be degradable like discarded vegetables which rapidly break down by natural processes. So non-degradable pollutants are difficult to remove. Now we will discuss about the atmospheric pollution. See, atmospheric pollution is divided into two parts. So one of the part is tropospheric pollution and another part is stratospheric pollution. So first we will discuss about the tropospheric pollution. What is tropospheric pollution? See, basically in tropospheric pollution, first we discuss about the gaseous air pollutants. So in tropospheric pollution, we will discuss about gaseous air pollutants. Basically what are gaseous air pollutants? These are the oxides of sulfur, nitrogen and carbon hydrogen, sulfides, hydrocarbon, ozone and other oxidants. So these are basically gaseous air pollutants. दीज आर दी ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ सल्फर, नाइट्रोजन एंड कार्बन, हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड, हाइड्रोकार्बन, ओजोन एंड अदर ऑक्सीडेंट्स ऑल कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ गैसियस एयर पॉल्यूटेंट्स. नाउ इन ट्रोपोस्फोरिक पॉल्यूशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पर्टिकुलेट पॉल्यूटेंट्स. व्हाट आर पर्टिकुलेट पॉल्यूटेंट्स? दीज आर डस्ट, मिस्ट, फ्यूम्स, स्मोक एंड स्मोक. सो दीज कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ पर्टिकुलेट पॉल्यूटेंट्स. सो फर्स्ट इन ट्रोपोस्फेरिक पॉल्यूशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ सल्फर. सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ सल्फर, देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन, देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द हाइड्रोकार्बन, देन ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ कार्बन. सी सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑल द टर्म्स इन ट्रोपोस्फेरिक पॉल्यूशन. सो इन ट्रोपोस्फेरिक पॉल्यूशन वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट गैसियस एयर पॉल्यूटेंट्स. So first we are going to discuss about oxides of sulfur. So basically the oxides of sulfur are produced. The oxides of sulfur are produced when sulfur containing fossil fuel is burned. So what is the main source of oxide of sulfur? These oxides of sulfur are produced when sulfur containing fossil fuel is burned. And the most common oxide of sulfur is sulfur dioxide. And the physical state of sulfur dioxide is gas. And also, the sulfur dioxide is poisonous to both animals and plants. So, this is the first gaseous air pollutants we have discussed, which is oxide of sulfur. And the oxide of sulfur is produced when sulfur containing fossil fuel is burned. The most common form of sulfur oxide is sulfur dioxide, which is found in the gaseous form and it poisonous to both animals and plants. Now see, basically the presence of particulate matter in polluted air. So the presence of particulate matter in polluted air catalyzes the oxidation of sulfur dioxide into sulfur trioxide. So basically the presence of particulate matter in the polluted air catalyzes the oxidation of SO2 into SO3, and this reaction can also be promoted by ozone and hydrogen peroxide. So basically ozone and hydrogen peroxide acts as a promoter means positive catalyst for this reaction. So we have seen the promoters in this reaction. The promoters for conversion of oxidation of sulfur dioxide into sulfur trioxide, we can use ozone and hydrogen peroxide as a promoter. Also the presence of particulate matter in polluted air is also catalyzing the oxidation of SO2 into SO3. So the first gaseous air pollutant we have discussed, which is oxide of sulfur. So main source of oxide of sulfur is the burning of fossil fuel, and the most common form of sulfur oxide is sulfur dioxide, which found in gaseous form and poisonous to both animal and plants. So in tropospheric pollution we have discussed the first part of gaseous air pollutant, which is oxide of sulfur. Now we will discuss about the oxide of nitrogen. See, the next is oxide of nitrogen. Basically, the oxide of nitrogen is obtained at high altitude when lightning strikes. So, the oxide of nitrogen is produced at high altitude when lightning strikes. Also when fossil fuel is burned, then the rate of production of NO2 is faster when nitric oxide reacts with ozone in the stratosphere. So this is another way for the formation of oxide of nitrogen. Basically, the formation of oxide of nitrogen at high altitude when lightning strikes, and when the fossil fuel is burned, when the fossil fuel is burned, then the rate of production of NO2 is faster. When nitric oxide reacts with ozone in the stratosphere, so when nitric oxide reacts with ozone in the stratosphere, then there is formation of oxide of nitrogen. Now we will discuss about the next gaseous air pollutant, which is hydrocarbon. Basically, what are hydrocarbon? As hydrocarbon is a combination of hydrogen and carbon, so hydrocarbon are composed of hydrogen and carbon only, and hydrocarbons are formed by incomplete combustion of fuel used in the automobiles. So if there is incomplete combustion of fuel used in the automobile, then hydrocarbons are formed. So hydrocarbon is also a gaseous air pollutant. Now we will discuss about the another gaseous pollutant, which is oxide of carbon. So we have discussed about the oxide of sulfur, oxide of nitrogen, next hydrocarbon. Now we are going to discuss the oxides of carbon. See, so basically we will discuss about the two oxides of carbon. One of them is carbon monoxide and another is carbon dioxide. Basically, carbon monoxide is formed by incomplete combustion of carbon. When there is incomplete combustion of carbon, then carbon monoxide gas is obtained. The next is carbon dioxide. See how carbon dioxide is produced. Basically, the burning of fossil fuel for energy. We are burning the fossil fuel for energy, and by decomposition of limestone. So basically, when we burn fossil fuel for energy, the carbon dioxide gas is released, and also CO2 gas is obtained by the decomposition of limestone during the manufacturing of cement. So we require the decomposition of limestone during the manufacturing of cement, and we know on decomposition of limestone we obtained CO2 gas. So basically it also emitted during volcanic eruptions. So we have done about the preparation of carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. So carbon monoxide is prepared by incomplete combustion of carbon, and carbon dioxide is prepared by burning of fossil fuel. When we burn the fossil fuel for energy, so CO2 gas is obtained. Also decomposition of limestone gives CO2, and also it is emitted during volcanic eruptions. Now we will discuss the next topic, which is global warming and greenhouse effect. See, which gases are responsible for the greenhouse effect? So basically, for greenhouse effect, gases responsible are CO2. CO2 is responsible for greenhouse effect. Also, methane is responsible for greenhouse effect. And ozone is also responsible for greenhouse effect. And also, chlorofluorocarbon. Chlorofluorocarbon, which we also called in short form CFC. Chlorofluorocarbon, CFC, and water vapors. So these gases are responsible for greenhouse effect. Therefore, we consider these gases in the category of greenhouse gases. So you may ask the options, which of the following gases are greenhouse gases? CO2 is a greenhouse gas. CH4 is also a greenhouse gas. Ozone is also a greenhouse gas. CFC is also a greenhouse gas. And water vapor is also a greenhouse gas. See, if the amount of CO2 crosses the delicate proportion of 0.03%. So if the amount of CO2 cross the delicate proportion of 0.03%, then the natural greenhouse balance may get disturbed. So what is the delicate proportion of CO2? See, if the amount of CO2 crosses the delicate proportion of 0.03%, then the natural greenhouse balance may get disturbed. So what are greenhouse gases? CO2, CH4, ozone, CFC, and water vapor all can behave as greenhouse gas. Now the next topic we are going to discuss about acid rain. See, what is acid rain? नॉर्मली वी नो द पीएच ऑफ रेन वाटर, नॉर्मली द पीएच ऑफ रेन वाटर इज 5.6. सो बेसिकली नॉर्मली द पीएच ऑफ रेन वाटर इज 5.6 एंड इट इज ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एच प्लस आयन फॉर्म बाय द रिएक्शन ऑफ रेन वाटर विद CO2 प्रेजेंट इन द एटमोसफेयर. सो बेसिकली वेन CO2 प्रेजेंट इन द एटमोसफेयर रिएक्ट्स विद वाटर वेपर इट फॉर्म H2CO3 विच इज कार्बोनिक एसिड एंड कार्बोनिक एसिड फर्नेस एच प्लस आयन एंड कार्बोनेट आयन. सो बेसिकली नॉर्मली रेन वाटर हैज अ पीएच ऑफ 5.6 एंड दिस पीएच ऑफ 5.6 इज ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एच प्लस आयन विच इज फॉर्म बाय रिएक्शन ऑफ रेन वाटर विच इज सो दिस एच प्लस आयन इज फॉर्म बाय द रिएक्शन ऑफ रेन वाटर विद CO2 प्रेजेंट इन द एटमोसफेयर. सी इफ द पीएच ऑफ रेन वाटर इफ द पीएच ऑफ रेन वाटर ड्रॉप्स बिलो 5.6 so if the pH of rainwater drops below 5.6 then the rain is considered as acid rain now we will discuss about the chemistry of acid rain. See what is the chemistry of acid rain. Basically what happens, gases like SO2 and NO2 after oxidation and reaction with water are major contributors to acid rain. So what are the major contributors to acid rain? SO2 and NO2 after oxidation and reaction with water are the major contributors to acid rain. Because we know polluted air usually contains particulate matter and these particulate matter catalyze the oxidation process. So because polluted air contains particulate matter and these particulate matter catalyze the oxidation of SO2 and NO2. So what is the chemistry of acid rain? We know SO2 and NO2 gas after oxidation and reaction with water major contributor to acid rain, and we know the oxidation of NO2 and SO2 is oxidized by the particulate matter present in the polluted air. See, basically also besides these ammonium salts are also formed. So except the oxide, so basically the oxide of SO2 and NO2 after oxidation and reaction with water contribute to acid rain, and also beside these ammonium salts are also formed, and these ammonium salts can be observed as an atmospheric haze. What is atmospheric haze? This is basically aerosol of fine particles. Now we can see these aerosol particles of oxides. So oxides are of SO2 and NO2, or we can say ammonium salts in rain drops settle down as wet deposition. So these aerosol particles of oxides or ammonium salts in rainwater settle down as wet deposition. So SO2 gas is also absorbed directly on both solid and liquid ground surfaces. So SO2 gas is also absorbed directly on both solid and liquid ground surfaces and is deposited as dry deposition. So basically we have seen SO2 and NO2 after oxidation and reaction with water major contributor to acid rain, and these oxides are catalyzed by the particulate matter present in the polluted air, and also beside these oxides ammonium salts are also formed, and these ammonium salts can be observed as an atmospheric haze, basically in the form of aerosol of fine particles. Now we will discuss about the harmful effects of acid rain. What are the harmful effects of acid rain? See, basically acid rain is harmful for agriculture, plants and trees, because it dissolves and washes away nutrients needed for their growth. So when acid rain dissolves, so acid rain on dissolving washes the nutrients needed for the growth of plants and trees. So acid rain is harmful for agriculture, plants and trees because it dissolves and washes away nutrients needed for their growth. Now see the next harmful effect of acid rain. The next harmful effect of acid rain is basically acid rain affects plants and animal life in aquatic ecosystem also. So aquatic ecosystem is also affected by the acid rain. And we know acid rain also causes respiratory ailments in human being and animal. So because of presence of SO2 and NO2, it can cause respiratory ailments in human being and animal. So we have discussed three harmful effects of acid rain till now. It also affects the aquatic ecosystem and also causes respiratory ailments in human being and animal. Now see, basically acid rain also corrodes water pipe. It also responsible for the corrosion of water pipe. So basically there is corrosion of water pipe resulting in the dissolution of heavy metals, such as iron, lead and copper into drinking water. So when water pipes are corroded by the acid rain, then the heavy metal will dissolve in the drinking water, and these heavy metals are like iron, lead and copper. So this drinking water is unfit for drinking. Now see the next harmful effect of acid rain. The next harmful effect of acid rain is building materials such as stone, marble or dolomite or mortar. Basically slate or metals are also corroded and weakened. So these building materials are corroded and weakened on reaction with acid rain because of formation of soluble compounds. We may see the reaction also. So basically this is the calcium carbonate. When reacts with the acid rain, so on reaction it forms calcium sulfate and evolution of CO2 gas and water. So basically this is the reaction due to which building material like marble or stone get corroded. So these are the harmful effects of acid rain. Now we will discuss our next topic, which is particulate pollutants. So what are particulate pollutants? Particulate pollutants are basically particulates in atmosphere. May be viable or non-viable. So it may be viable or non-viable. See, what is viable and non-viable? We can see. Basically, the viable particulates are, example, bacteria is a viable particulate, fungi also viable particulate, and algae also viable particulate. Basically these particulates are minute living organisms. So these viable particulates are bacteria, fungi, algae, and these are minute living organisms. Basically these organisms are dispersed in the atmosphere. So in particulate matter, what are particulate matter? These are the particulates in atmosphere. It may be viable or non-viable. What is viable? So basically the viable particulate are minute living organisms that are dispersed in atmosphere, and these minute living organisms are bacteria, fungi, algae, etc. So basically these viable particulates Now, as human beings are allergic to some of the fungi found in air. We know the human beings are allergic to some of the fungi found in air. They can also cause plant disease. So these viable particulate can also cause plant disease. Now we will discuss about the non-viable particulates. See, what are non-viable particulates? Basically, the non-viable particulates are smoke, dust, mist, and fumes. So basically, what are non-viable particulates? Smoke comes under the category of non-viable particulate. Dust also comes in the category of non-viable. And mist also come under the category of non-viable, and fumes also comes under the category of non-viable. So first we are going to discuss about the first non-viable particulate, which is smoke. See, basically smoke particulates consist of solid or mixture of solid with liquid. So what are the constituents of smoke particulates? Smoke particulates basically consists of solid or mixture of solid and liquid particles. So basically these mixture of solid and liquid particles are formed during combustion of organic matter. So what are the constituents of smoke particles? Basically smoke particulates consist of solid or mixture of solid and liquid particles form during combustion of organic matter. For example, cigarette smoke or smoke from burning of fossil fuel. So cigarette smoke or smoke from burning of fossil fuel or garbage and dry leaves all will give smoke particulates. The next non-viable particulate we are going to discuss is dust. See, what is dust? Basically, dust is composed of fine solid particles, and the size of dust over 1 micrometer in diameter. So dust is composed of fine solid particles, and the size of dust particle is over 1 micrometer in diameter. So basically dust is produced during crushing, grinding, and attrition of solid materials. Also, sand is obtained from sandblasting, sawdust from woodworks also produces sawdust, pulverized coal and cement, and fly ash from factories are some typical examples of the formation of this particulate emission, which we are calling dust. So basically dust is composed of fine solid particles, and the size of these particles is over 1 micrometer in diameter, and these are produced during crushing or grinding. Also, it is obtained from sandblasting, sawdust from the woodworks, and also from pulverized coal, cement, and fly ash from factories are the some typical examples of particulate emission of dust. So we have discussed two non-viable particulates in this class. So one of the non-viable particulate we have discussed is smoke, and the next particulate, non-viable particulate, we have discussed about dust. So smoke and dust we have discussed now. So in the next class we will discuss about two another non-viable particulates, which are mist and fumes.